How I felt when I found out I was pregnant was shocked and a little bit scared, but a lot excited. You know, it's obviously a huge change and it's not something that I planned for, but it's been the best surprise and such a blessing. The first person I told was Alex, my fiance, and it's actually funny because we weren't in the same state. I was in Missouri, he was in New York, and he was supposed to be coming to Missouri the next day. I'm like, okay, you know what? I'm just gonna wait to tell him until the next day. No. Immediately called him and I saw he was in an Uber. I was like, okay, let me just wait at least till he gets back to the apartment. Nope, slipped right out. Like I couldn't even hold it in. So I told him within like 30 seconds of the call.
3, 2, 1.
I've talked to Candace about what her journey was like. I've talked to Bria Hartley about what her journey was like. Derek is here, talked to her a little bit. Just trying to get kind of as much information as I can on, you know, what they did to come back as soon as they could, like what their recovery was like, just all these questions. They've already gone through it and they're doing so amazing at it. So I want to try to get like a cheat sheet before my little rug rat gets here. I thought about my career almost right away when I found out because it was right after the season. Kind of a lot of things went into that. You know, some things made sense, like I felt so tired towards the end of the season. And then also, you know, what am I gonna do for next season? I'm really early in my career. Just things like that, because it was, you know, a surprise. It was just like trying to figure out everything at once, just, you know, pivoting and remapping out your life and how it's gonna look. So I was immediately trying to calculate in my brain, you know, when am I gonna be due? When is the season starting? And at that point, again, it was right after season that I found out, so I didn't know what the schedule was. I have not ruled out that I'm not gonna play. You know, I think it's gonna be really hard, and I definitely am not making any promises because I have no idea what this journey is gonna look like, but I would love to, you know, be able to play a few games with Sil for her last season. You know, I'd love to be able to be ready for the World Cup. There's a lot of goals that I have. And again, I feel like I'm just gonna, you know, take it one day at a time, see how my body feels and listen to that. But definitely, you know, now it's a goal of mine that I wanna try to push towards. I feel good right now. I'm in my second trimester and they say that's the easiest one. So I'm just waiting for, I guess, that third one to hit and everything to go downhill, because that's what everyone keeps saying. So that's exciting. But I feel pretty good right now, you know? I've had a relatively, thank goodness, like easy pregnancy, so I'm just hoping that continues and, you know, everything. She's healthy, I'm healthy. Just, you know, praying for the best. So today is Tuesday, March 22nd, and today I'm officially 7.5 months, 30 weeks, so only around 10 more weeks to go, which is so crazy. It's going by so, so fast. I can't even believe it. A little baby bump update. She's getting big. Can see all that stuff we got in the background there.
Do you have any nerves about anything? Are you nervous? Are you?
I mean, you know my personality. I don't. Nerves isn't like a thing with me. It's more of anxious. Is probably the better word. I don't. But for me, it's more of working with you to like kind of just like learn as we go. And I think that's what's gonna be fun, but also I'm more so nervous into what we decide her name is gonna be, because we haven't figured that
she's
out
yet. She's a nameless baby right now.
So, it's not ideal, but to be determined.
To be determined. We love you, nameless baby.
Wow. Waving! Did you see that's the arm going everywhere? The head, the body, those are arms right there.
Oh my gosh.
Let me show you legs, right there.
Yeah, I see it.
Yeah, so some life changes that I've had to make. Just the way that I work out, like the way that my body moves is a lot different. The way that I eat has been a lot different, trying to eat, you know, healthy. And so my workouts have changed a lot because in the beginning I was doing a lot of basketball stuff, but it was starting like hurt more and my body wasn't moving the same way. So I'm really just kind of in the gym trying to do cardio and lifting, not so much basketball stuff right now. A lot of the at-home exercises I'm doing are like stretching, and I still go to the gym, so I can do, you know, cardio on the treadmill, like incline walks. I do, you know, arm exercises, leg exercises the same way that I would have before. It feels really weird being off the court for this long, and it feels like in 2020 where our season ended in October and we didn't play again until July. It's hard to go that long without playing. Yeah, I think it's definitely going to be a challenge to get back on the court, but I'm a hard worker. I'm going to do whatever I need to, you know, get my body back in shape, and I'm really excited to see how that goes. I'm really excited to introduce her to basketball. Not so much basketball for herself, like I would love if she played, obviously, but it's not like I'm going to force her to play, but I'm really excited to bring her around my teammates to have that family connection. They're all really excited, and I'm so excited for her to have so many amazing role models that she'll have in my team. And to see her at the game with, you know, her little jersey on and Alex holding her on the sidelines, I think is going to be really, really cute.